the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life for the world to come. Amen. Heavenly Father, we do come before you, desiring to be good stewards of our time, talent, and treasure of all that you've given to us. Please help us further your gospel in this place and time, as we now present to you our needs and intentions.
For Pope Francis, may he be protected and guided by the Holy Spirit as he continues to guide the flock entrusted to him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of authority, that terrorism in its many manifestations be wiped from the face of the earth and be replaced by peace and security for all humanity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we come to the end of Vocation Week, we continue to pray for Andy Erdman and Lorenzo Cabral as they journey towards the priesthood, and Rick Weil in diaconate formation. May the Lord continue to bless them as they answer his call. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all veterans, as we celebrate Veterans Day, may the Lord bless them. For those in combat, may God keep them safe. And for those who sacrificed their lives to preserve freedom for our nation, may they receive their eternal reward. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered at this table, may we renew our commitment to love Jesus, love as Jesus loves. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of this Mass, whom we pray for in a special way, Timothy Hartnett, and for our own prayers and intentions, which we offer now in prayerful silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died in faith, may they be granted the rewards and blessings of the kingdom, especially those who have passed on this week from our parish and faith community. Gregory Faulkner, Rose Riccioni. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we offer you these, our many needs and intentions. Humbly we pray, please hear us and help us through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our ushers will now take up the collection.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of time and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all of its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Gregory the Great, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church graciously. Grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of that peace. Peace be with you, Father.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Took oil and
Before we conclude, just a reminder that many things are coming up right now. The dinner auction is this Friday, and of course, first time back in person at Salvatore's since the pandemic. And Friday and Saturday after Thanksgiving, the return of the craft show, first time since after the pandemic. So we're thankful for so many people who are working hard to bring these things back. And the giving tree is out there in the vestibule for those who are looking to participate, as we always do, in providing gifts for those perhaps less fortunate than we are. And the young people, good news is they kind of ran out of the tubes of M&Ms, which means many people took them, which is a good thing. They do have candy bars that they are also having available there for a little donation if you'd like to support youth ministry. And check the bulletin, too, for the many, many things going on to be involved in here at St. Greg's. Let us pray. There we go. Got it. Perfect. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God. We offer the prayer for renewal. In every age, O God, you've called us to be your people, to be your church. In this time, we begin anew to discern the pathways that will lead us, your people, closer to you. Continually bless our journey as we proclaim your good news. Celebrate your saving presence among us. Serve others with charity and justice, and steward the world you've entrusted to our care. Send your Spirit to lead and guide our Emmaus journey as we commit ourselves to the renewal of our church. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.